First problem, the orbit of the Earth is an ellipse with eccentricity 1 by 60 with the Sun at one of its foci, the major axis being approximately 186 into 10 power 6 miles in length. Then find the shortest and longest distances of the Earth from the Sun. So given that the orbit of the Earth is an ellipse, that is, this is the orbit of the Earth, that is, the Earth rotates around the Sun in this orbit. And also given that with its eccentricity is equal to 1 by 60, that is, given that E is equals to 1 by 60, the Sun at one of its foci. So given that one of the foci is equals to Sun, so this is the Sun. The major axis being approximately 186 into 10 power 6 miles in length. The length of the major axis is given, that is, the value of 2A is given. This is 186 into 10 power 6. Length of the major axis being 186 into 10 power 6. Now find the shortest and longest distances of the Earth from the Sun. Earth rotates around the Sun in the orbit. For example, first we take that this is the position of the Earth, E1. E1 is the position of the Earth. And what is the distance between Earth and Sun? Which is SE1. And for example, suppose this is the position of the Earth, that is E2. Then what is the distance between the distance? SE2 is the distance between the Sun and the Earth. For example, this is the position of the Earth, E3. Then what is the distance between them? SE3. And for example, this is the position of the Earth. What is this? This is A dash. This is the position of the Earth. Then what is the distance between the Earth and the Sun? SA dash. And for example, this is the position of the Earth. Then what is the distance between them? SA. Now clearly from the diagram, what is the shortest distance between the Sun and the Earth? SA. Here SA is the shortest distance between the Sun and the Earth. And what is the longest distance between the Sun and the Earth? SA dash. This is the longest distance between the Sun and the Earth. Now this is the center of the ellipse. Now we want the values of SA and SA dash. What is SA? SA is nothing but CA minus CS. What is CA value? CA is equals to A. And what is CS value? This is AE. This between the center and the focus, AE. Now what is SA value? SA is nothing but CA minus CS. And what is SA dash value? SA dash is equals to CS plus CA dash. Here CA dash is equals to small a, CA is equals to small a. These two values are small a. But from the diagram, SA and SA dash. Now we want to find those two values. That's all. That's a given problem. So first we write the given data. Given that eccentricity E is equals to 1 by 60 and major axis being approximately 186 into 10 power 6. So given the length of the major axis, that is 2A is equals to 180 into 10 power 6. That is the value of A is equals to 93 into 10 power 6. Now we want the shortest and longest distances of the Earth from the Sun. Therefore first we are taking the shortest distance. Therefore clearly from the diagram we are taking these values. The shortest distance from Earth to Sun is equals to, the shortest distance from Earth to Sun is equal to, which is nothing but SA. When the Earth comes to this position, then this is the nearest point from the Sun. So SA is the shortest distance. So SA, and SA is equals to CA minus CS, that is A minus AE. From the diagram we have that value is equals to A minus AE. What is A into 1 minus E? A minus E is equals to A into 1 minus E. What is A value? 93 into 10 power 6 into 1 minus 1 by 60. And this is equals to 93 into 10 power 6 into 59 by 60. After taking the simplification, we will get the answer as 9145 into 10 power 4. This is the first answer. And the longest distance. And the longest distance from Earth to Sun is equals to longest distance, that is SA dash. S is the position of the Sun, and here when the Earth comes to the place of A dash, then this is the farthest point from the Sun. So this is the longest distance. So SA dash is equals to value, SA dash is equals to CS plus CA dash, that is A plus AE. A common we get A into 1 plus E, that is A value 93 into 10 power 6 into 1 plus E. 1 plus 1 by 60, 61 by 60. After taking the simplification, we will get the answer as 9455 into 10 power 4. That's all. That's the answer. Next problem. A man running on a race course notices that the sum of the distances of two flag posts from him is always 10 meter and the distance between the two flag posts is 8 meter. Then find the equation of the race course traced by the man. So given that a man running on a race course, this is the race course. Race course means that is in the shape of the ellipse. So one man running on the race course. And observe that the sum of the distances of two flag posts from him is equals to 10 meters. That is sum of the distances of the two flag posts. First we are taking two flag posts which are S, S dash. These are the flag posts. The man notices that the sum of the distances of these two flag posts from him is equals to 10. That is, suppose this is the position of the man. The position of the man is P. He observed that, he noticed that the sum of the distances of the two flag posts from him is equals to 10. That is, the distance of the first flag post from him is equals to SP and the distance of the second flag post from him is equal to S dash P. He observed that sum of the distances is equals to 10. That is, SP plus S dash P is equals to 10. That is the given data. Given that, SP plus S dash P is equals to 10. Now, these are the fixed points. And also given that the distance between the two flag posts is equals to 8. That is, distance between these two points, that is 8 meters, which is nothing but, so without loss of generality, we are taking these two points as S, S dash foci. Then what is the distance between the foci? 2 AE. So given that 2 AE is equals to 8, then the value of A is equals to 4. And what is the value of SP plus S dash P? Already we solved this problem. The value of SP plus S dash P is nothing but 2a. If P is any point on the ellipse, then the sum of the distances of the point P from the two foci is equal to 2a, length of the major axis. So SP plus S dash P is equal to 2a. That is, 2a is equals to 10, then the value of A is equals to 5. A is equals to 5, then the value of A is equals to 4/5. Now what is the given question? Find the equation of the race course traced by the man. What is the equation of the race course? What is the race course means ellipse here. What is the equation of the ellipse? That is the given question. So what is the equation of ellipse? X square by A square plus Y square by B square is equals to 1. So already we have that A is equals to 5 and E is equal to 4/5. Now we are finding the value of B by using the formula B square is equals to 1 minus E square. That's all. This is the processor. We take that, let P be the position of the man and S, S dash be the positions of the two flag posts. These are the flag posts. Now we are writing the given data. What is given? Given that sum of the distances of the two flag posts from him is equals to 10. That is, SP plus S dash P is equals to 10. And also given that the distance between the two flag posts is equals to 8. That is, S dash is equals to 8. And already we know that the formulas are, these are the formulas. The formula for SP plus S dash P is equals to 2A and S into S dash is equals to 2AE. Therefore, the value of 2A is equals to 10, right? And the value of 2AE is equals to 8. Here, A is equals to 5 and A is equals to 4. That is, A is equals to 4/5. Since here we have A is equals to 5. This B square formula is B square is equals to A square into 1 minus A square. That is 25 into 1 minus 16/25 is equals to 25 into 9/25. Therefore, the value of B square is equals to 9. Therefore, equation of ellipses, X square by A square plus Y square by B square is equals to 1. That is, the answer is X square by 25 plus Y square by 9 equals to 1. That's all. Next problem. A line of fixed length A plus B moves so that its ends are always on the two fixed perpendicular straight lines. Prove that the marked point on the line which divides this line into portions of lengths A and B describes an ellipse. And also find the eccentricity of the ellipse if A is equals to 8 and B is equals to 12. So given that a line of fixed length A plus B moves so that its ends are always on the two fixed perpendicular straight lines. So first we are taking the two perpendicular straight lines, which are the two fixed perpendicular straight lines. Without loss of generality, we are taking these two lines as coordinate axis. This is the line of the fixed length A plus B. Now it moves so that its ends are on the fixed perpendicular straight lines. This is the line of length A plus B. Now prove that a marked point on the line which divides this line into portions of lengths A and B describes an ellipse. For that, first we are taking one point here. This is the P point. The point P divides the line segment into two portions of lengths A and B. So this divides the total line segment into two parts such that the length of the first part is equal to A and the length of the second part is equal to B. Now we want to show that the point P describes an ellipse. That is, we want to show that the point P lies on the ellipse. Now this is the ellipse. Now we want to show that the point P lies on the ellipse. Further, first we are taking the coordinates of P is equals to x comma y, and we are drawing one perpendicular from P to the x axis, which is taken as PN, and again we are drawing one perpendicular from P to the y axis, which is taken as PM. So clearly from the diagram we have that PN is equals to y and the value of PM is equals to x. This is x coordinate and this is y coordinate. And for example, angle between these two lines is equal to theta here. Angle between the line and x-axis is equal to theta. Then the angle at this place is also equal to theta. Since these two triangles are similar triangles, this is A and this is B. Now, from the diagram, first we take the triangle PNA. From this triangle, we take the value of sine theta. What is sine theta value? Opposite by hypotenuse. That is, sine theta is equal to y by b. And from this triangle PBM, we are taking the value of cos theta. What is cos theta? Adjacent by hypotenuse, that is x by a. So sin theta is equals to y by b and cos theta is equals to x by a. Then the squares to these equations, yeah. And we get sin square theta is equals to y square by b square and cos square theta is equals to x square by a square. By adding these two equations, we will get the answer x square by a square plus y square by b square is equals to cos square theta plus sin square theta, that is equals to 1, which represents an ellipse. So show that the point P describes an ellipse, that is, we want the point P lies on the ellipse. So clearly we get the equation of ellipse, that is, the point P lies on the ellipse. And also given that find the eccentricity of the ellipse when a is equals to 8 and b is equals to 9. A is equals to 8, b is equal to 9 means this is the second case. We take the eccentricity formula as square root of b square minus a square by b square. That's all. Let AB be given line of length a plus b. Let AB be given line of length a plus b. And PX comma y be a point on the line. Point on AB. From triangle PNA, the value of sine theta is equals to opposite by hypotenuse, that is y by b. From the triangle PBM, the value of cos theta is equals to adjacent by hypotenuse, that is x by a. Plus sine square theta is equals to here y square by b square, and the value of cos square theta is equals to x square by a square. Now adding these two equations, that is sin square theta plus cos square theta is equals to y square by b square plus x square by a square. That is, this value is equals to 1. 1 is equals to x square by a square plus y square by b square. Therefore, x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1, means it represents an ellipse. Therefore, the point P describes an ellipse. Therefore, P describes an ellipse. And also find the eccentricity when a is equals to 8 and b is equals to 12. So given that a is equals to 8 and b is equals to 12, now and we find the eccentricity by using the formula e is equals to square root of b square minus a square by b square, and this is equals to 144 minus 64 by 144, which is equals to root 80 by 144. This is 4 root 5 by 12 equals to root 5 by 3. That's all.